ওয়ালাইকুম। আইসিটিআর গুরু আইটি প্রশিক্ষণ অনলাইন ফোরামে আপনাকে স্বাগত। আলহামদুলিল্লাহ, আজকে আমরা আমাদের 12-13 ক্লাস শুরু করবো, তাই না? 13 ক্লাস শুরু করবো আজকে জুলাই 2018। তো আমরা শুরু করি। দেখেন, আমাদের গতদিনে আমরা চ্যাপ্টার চ্যাপ্টার 9-10 নিয়ে আলোচনা করতেছিলাম। আমার বই চ্যাপ্টার 9 নিয়ে আলোচনা করতেছিলাম, কি বলে, ক্লাস, অবজেক্ট এবং মেথড। এখন আমাকে সংক্ষেপে বলেন যে ক্লাস কি? হোয়াট ইজ এ ক্লাস? হোয়াট ইজ অ্যান অবজেক্ট?
ক্লাস ইজ এ ইউজার ডিফাইন ডেটা টাইপ।
ইয়েস।
এন্ড অবজেক্ট ইজ এ এলিমেন্ট অফ ক্লাস।
ইয়েস, ভেরি গুড, ভেরি গুড।
রো ফ্লাওয়ার ইজ এ ক্লাস এন্ড রো ইজ এ অবজেক্ট।
ইয়েস, ভেরি গুড,
নাইস,
ক্লিয়ার?
ইয়েস।
ওকে, দ্যাট মিন্স an object is an entity, a thing, okay, an element, okay. So every element in this world has a type, its own type, right? If you say pen is a type, right? If you say paper, piece of paper, it has a type, okay? So every type has its own characteristics, right? This is how one type is different than another type, right? So for instance, pen is different than a piece of paper, right? This is like, we say it's a human. If we say animal and then human, there are two different types, right? These are two different types. And animals have their own characteristics, and like for instance, humans have their own characteristics, but there might have some common characteristics. Common characteristics, but it's not necessary, right? Okay, but there must be some special characteristics of each type, right? This is why we distinguish each type from another type, right? Now let us come to object. Object is an entity, an instance of a type. Right? You mentioned that a rose. A rose is a type of a flower, a specific flower. Like this, that means flower is a class.
Yeah.
And a rose is a
type of flower.
Type of flower. Yes. Okay, so then if you bring 2 roses here, or 5 pieces of roses here, right? Mm-hmm. All of these are rose, ones of single common class.
Mm-hmm.
But all of these 5 pieces have distinct
colors.
Maybe same color, but distinct characteristics. Okay, at least if they are same size, same red, same color, same scent, but there might have at least one special characteristic for which you can distinguish this object from that object. Right? Okay. So if you understand this, then you understand a lot. You understand the basic thing of object-oriented programming, right? So object-oriented programming is the concept of program, making a computer program like in the fashion of real life object, right? So then when we say we discussed in last class, my test project or something, no matter which project we are talking about. Discuss, okay? So if you read my book, you will see there are a lot. So what is the format of class declaration? A class declaration starts with a class keyword, right? And then followed by a class name, and then followed by a opening second bracket, and it ended with an opening second bracket.
Mm-hmm.
In some languages like C++, this second bracket is ended by a semicolon, but not in Java.
Mm-hmm.
In some programming languages, this this second bracket is ended by another semicolon, but it's not in Java. So a class contains two types of member. One type is member variable, and another type is member function, right?
Member function.
Okay, member function, why member functions are needed? Member function are used in order to access the member variable,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yes.
So that means a class, a type, class means a type, must have at least one member variable,
mm-hmm.
one characteristic, at least one, right?
Mm-hmm.
And yet it must have at least one
function.
Member function,
which is a method.
Mm-hmm. The method will be used to access the
variable
or characteristics, okay? So for instance, here is a class, student class. It's a very simple class, student class. It starts with class. So class is a keyword. It always starts with lowercase. Class, then student is the name of this class, its type. So the class type always is by default, by tradition, okay, class name start with an uppercase number, uppercase letter, okay? The S is in uppercase, should be. If it is in lowercase, it will not be an arrow, but it will make an point. So, okay. So, bhai. Can you please tell me what are these? What are these integer rule? What do you understand by integer rule?
Integer rule, like that,
if we declare an object of this class,
member will
be a student, right? Student will have a role. The role will be identified by number. We assigned by number, right?
Yeah.
And the name. So these are the characteristics of this class. So role, name, and mark. These are the member variables, right? So member variable declaration. So within the class, you always put the just declare. You don't assign. If you assign, so then for instance, role equal to 101. Then it is fixed. You can do that, but it is fixed. You can say this is fixed, right? Okay. Then a student will have a name, so that name will be string type. A student will have some marks, that will be float type. So what is this one? Integer set data. Salam bhai.
Set data is before get data.
Yeah, that is not a matter. There is no get data here. The get data, this one is display. Instead of get data, we put display here.
You said there is a function.
Yes, it is a method.
Okay.
So if it is inside class, for class member, if it is a function in the class, we say it's method.
But we have to set data to get the result, right?
Yes.
To get this
one,
to get the result.
Set data, we used to set that result. Set the variable, role, set mark, set name. And display will be, but display or get data will be used to display.
Yes.
Okay, we can put it display, any name we can put, give you any name, reasonable name, okay? By convention, the variables and methods are started with lowercase name. So there is a mistake over here. So then it's not, so we should say n is in lowercase, we should say n in for. This is convention. Naming convention, we should say lowercase. Okay, but it's not an error, just convention. Okay, so here we see this is class, right? What is the class name? No, class name is vehicle. Vehicle is the class name, right? This public is the access modifier. Okay, that means this class is a keyword. Public is the access modifier. We will learn in a minute what is access, what are access modifiers, okay? Then private, and then so this access modifier is for class, and these are also access modifier for member variable. This is private, this is private, this is private. Private means so if a class member's access modifier is private, then no one else, no other object outside will know this. Will not be able to access this unless the object tells this, disclose this, right? So if I ask your social security number, unless you tell me your social security number, I will not be able to learn your social security number, right? Your social security number is private to you. Even you know, if you apply for social security number for your whole family together at the same time, they will not give serial number.
Yes, so
they will not give you serial number, they will give different number.
Yeah. So here's the thing.
Yes.
If you put like string, if you put private in front of them, so it's going to be private. Nobody can access that.
Yeah, for this we need to get an unsetter in order
okay.
to access this one.
Okay.
We need to get an unsetter. But if you make it public, if you can make it public, then other people can hack it. Other objects can hack it.
Yeah.
Main for main method and hack it. Okay, so okay, time to time we will discuss about this. Last time, so we declare objects, right? So what is the for instance? Let us consider it. For instance, let us type consider the rectangle is a class. So how do you declare? If it's integer class, this rectangle is a type, right?
Yes.
So if it is an integer, then you put integer my rectangle, right? In Java, how do we declare a variable? At the beginning, you put a type,
integer
type. Then you put the variable name, right? Here, same thing. This is a rectangle is a type. Okay. So when you say class, we will not tell you this is a type, but you have to remember a class is a type, right?
Mm-hmm.
Please put it in your brain. So when you say class, you will remember it is a type, okay? So rectangle is a type, right? My rectangle, okay? And then my rectangle is a new rectangle. So what is the difference between first line and second line? First line is a rectangle, my rectangle. That means it says that you will define a rectangle, and when the rectangle will be created, we create a object using new operator. Using the new operator in Java, which is lowercase. So unless you use new operator, then its object is not created. So then the question is, what is this one? Rectangle, then the same name, class name, then what is this one with the parenthesis? Why we have a parenthesis, right? So this is a constructor. Yeah, constructor. In the next chapter we will learn today is constructor. Constructor is a method. So it says constructor is a special kind of method, member method, okay, that is called initiated automatically when an object is created. Okay, constructor is a fun method that is not needed to call explicitly, that is invoked or called automatically. We can do this thing, right? In our real world, we can do this thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
We know that, but okay, so if you call a Uber, if you need a ride, Uber, okay?
Mm-hmm.
If you make a phone call or make an app order, request for an Uber.
Mm-hmm.
If someone comes, a very handsome person, but without any car, without any vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
He said, okay, I have my driver license, I have my Uber license, but my car is in a shop,
yeah.
A mechanic shop.
Yeah.
What do you think? It's stupid, that guy, right? So that means, when you call a Uber, that you expect that the guy will come, the vehicle will come automatically, right? Right?
The guy,
the driver will bring the vehicle with him, right? So that is constructor. Vehicle is constructor with him, right? He's integrated part. You cannot distinct a driver from a Uber driver from his vehicle.
Which is kind of the default thing.
Yes, default thing.
Yes. Whenever
you understand?
Call the Uber, it's supposed to be half the car.
Yes.
So it's not going to be a driver with a car.
Yes.
So
you understand that this is the constructor, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the integrated part. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But, okay. So, well, I will tell you more about constructor in a minute. But let us say. So So what happens when we create a constructor? When you call a constructor? When you call a constructor, it takes space in memory, computer memory. Takes space, real space, right? The last time, okay, we gave a real example that you plan that you will have a baby and you will name that your baby as a my rectangle. My rect, okay? So unless your baby is born, right? You cannot get his certificate. You cannot get his real position, right?
Yes.
So the new operator is used to create an object. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
So without a new operator, so this line is a declaration and this line is initialization. Initialization. So how it is initialization? So when you declare an object, so they, if you say that, oh, I will have a baby, I will name it as a rectangle, then it will have null. Null means nothing.
But because
it's
our baby, we can give his or her name.
Yeah,
yes.
Rectangle is a name, but.
Yes, you can name.
Unless,
my rectangle is a name, then this is something. You can do baby shower, you can do a lot of programs, no problem. But can you get social security number?
No,
okay.
Birth certificate.
You cannot get birth certificate. So the new operator is needed, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the baby needs to be born, right?
Yeah.
So here is same thing for object. Object need to be born. How we born if object is born? When you use new operator and with the constructor. This the name is the same name of class name with parenthesis. That is empty constructor. The empty constructor, we must give parenthesis. This is constructor. That means this constructor will create the object. Okay? For instance, here. So here is rectangle is class name, right? Rectangle is class name. My rectangle is name of an object, right? And what is this name new? new is a keyword that dynamically creates object. Okay, it creates object. And what is the rectangle? This rectangle with parenthesis. This is the same name of class, but it is called constructor. Okay, that's simple.
So constructor belongs to class.
No. Constructor the same name of his class. If we go chapter 10, you will see the constructor. That the constructor first characteristic of a constructor is that his class, his name is the same name of his class.
Yeah.
Since it's a method, it will have the parenthesis. After null.
Okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So even it exactly the same name. It will have exactly the same name. When a method's name is exactly the same name of a class. Right? That is called, that method is called constructor. Okay? A class may have multiple constructors. Okay. If a class does not have any constructor, then we assume that there is an empty constructor. By default, there is an empty constructor.
Mm-hmm.
Empty constructor means like this: the constructor within the parent, within the second bracket, there is nothing, empty. Right. So by default, every class has at least one constructor. Right. That is the default constructor or empty constructor. Default constructor.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So a class may have, so can you please tell me what is the constructor name here in this line of code, lines of code? Is there any constructor here?
Yes.
The class name is student.
Yes.
Public student, that one is the constructor.
And what is the constructor? Where is the constructor? Is there any constructor here?
Yes, here the public
student. Yes. Yeah, this is the student and this is the... So constructor is a method. How do we know if this is a method? It will have a name, right?
Yeah.
It will have parenthesis. It may have something. It may have something within the parenthesis or not.
You
learn what happens if there is something within the parenthesis.
It is a must, like have parenthesis for constructor.
No method.
Method.
Yeah, this constructor is a method. But constructor, so every method's name. Ended with how do we know this is a method? When we see the parenthesis. After name, we see parenthesis. But with the class, there is no parenthesis, right?
Yeah.
the constructor doesn't have any return type.
Yes. Yes. That's good. So if we go some characters of constructor, then you will see constructor's name is the same name of its class name, right? That constructor must be public. The constructor cannot return a value. We will learn today. We will learn what is return value. So then, why constructor is needed? The constructor is an essential thing. Sometimes, like for instance, we want to define some default value of an object. If we want to do that, we can use constructor. For instance, when you call a Uber driver, we expect that the Uber driver will bring his vehicle. Right? So the vehicle will be added in the driver constructor. The driver constructor as an integrated part.
Mm-hmm.
So driver, that means that when you call a Uber driver, he cannot leave his car, his vehicle. He must come with his vehicle. He may be late, that is not another issue. That is not an issue. And when he arrives, he must bring his vehicle. Okay? So a very, very simple constructor is very simple. So there are some default constructor, argument constructor. You don't need to learn all about this. Okay? Just if you did watch the videos of chapter 10, Mangalana, one time. And if you read the book of this, very simple. When you understand chapter 9, chapter 10 is very simple. So we learn how do objects communicate with each other? Through message passing, right? A human. So I'm a person is a human, right? An object, right? Okay. And Shalom is an object. I am the human, right? How do I communicate with him? We do message passing, right? How do we message pass? I ask him a question through a method. And he replies through another method, right? Okay. So this is how we communicate. Similarly, other objects in object-oriented programming communicate with each other through message passing. So we will see. So in this book, so for instance, here. So this is a method, this is a method. Send data, this method. This one is another an object. So this one is a student. His student has his role, his name and marks, right? Whom role, name and marks, right? For instance, this student's name is 101, name is Mahdi, marks like 58. And this student has his role like 102, his name Munim, and this marks. Okay, now tell me that. Is it possible that all of these students S1 and S2 will or may have all same characteristics?
No.
Or same values?
No, two different.
At least one of these values should be different, right?
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's the same object.
Yeah.
Same student, right? If their name, role, marks, everything is same, then they cannot say these are two different students. Same student, right? Yes, at least one different character.
Yeah.
Okay, so then how this object communicate with each other? So this object will pass his data through the same data. This object will pass his data to this. And this object will pass to display, then this object will pass to display. And maybe that this set data may call display, display may call set data, but it's not required. But maybe. But on another thing, that this object cannot be able to get this object value, unless this value are private, public. If it is public, then key, you can get it. Okay? No. Then how do they do it? Through the getter and setter.
Mm-hmm.
So then we discuss the dot operator, right? Why do we use dot operator?
Yes.
Wow. In English, we say of, right? Mother of. Like the A is of Mahadi, right? That's a Bangla will have Mahadi air. Air means we use dot, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So that's mean we should, how do we pronounce, how do we make this word in English? No, this system.
Air.
Yes, system, this is a class, right?
Yes.
System class. Class name, a class name. How do I know this is class name? It started with an uppercase number.
Mm-hmm.
Uppercase letter, right? Mm-hmm. System is a class, and then this is an object. How do we know it's an object? Always object or always lowercase.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then so object is another dot. We are calling this print method. Print method is defined within the system class. Okay, that means we are doing system class air objected madhume. Have a system class air print method. Okay, invoke course, call course. That is the rule. So this is the point. This is easier way. Otherwise, you could say if the program developer who developed this program, if they pick off, so we could pick off. Let's say empty. That could be, that might be meaningful. But it's easier. This is convention. So we understand that dot means off. For instance, we assume we know something for the separate class size, right? We understand plus means 2 plus 3. Then we don't write 2 plus 3, right? When you just type in a single character plus, we understand this means plus, right? In our real life, we use a lot of shortcuts. Right? So dot is a shortcut. Okay. Now, this is an important thing. For the last thing, we need to understand. So, for instance, let me try to understand this one. This is a class, right? For instance, this class will have some member variable, right? For instance, it will have some member variable or it will have some member function, right? For instance, it has some member function 1 and just another member function 2, right? When you declare two objects, object 1 and object 2, so these two objects will take place in different places in memory, right? We call two students here, right? So they will sit in different chairs,
chair.
Different positions, right? They won't be able to sit in the same chair. The same thing. Then there's something more about the heat and this. So you don't need to understand this about this. Again, it's a high level. Okay, that's another thing we need to understand. What is reference? Okay, reference is a representative. Okay, sometimes, for instance, we know if the chairman is busy. If the chairman is busy, sometimes he sends a representative, right? Another like counselor or member, a representative to do his work, right?
Like
an example, when the manager,
right?
Yes.
He or she is
on the table. Yes. Same thing. Like yes. Reference. Yes. So, same thing we use reference. Like, for instance, here, data type 1, data type, like if we say this one data type. So, this every reference has its own data type, right? Manager is the type, manager.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the variable 1 and variable 2. So, this, okay, sorry, this is. I will take. We don't need it. Okay, actually, you don't need it for. Let me see quickly. I can tell you something. Okay, we got it. For instance, here, what do you understand by this line? Rectangle R1 equal to new rectangle. What do you understand this?
Yeah, first rectangle is object and next one is constructor.
No, first one is class.
Class.
Yeah. Because the
rectangle should be
there. When we write this one, it will a new rectangle will be created with name R1, right?
Uh-huh.
R1 will take some place in memory, right?
Mm-hmm.
For instance, we say R1 a rectangle. A rectangle will have, we assume that, length and width, height and width, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
A rectangle. like length and width, white or beige. So okay. Now if you say rectangle 2 equal to rectangle 1, then it will allocate another rectangle, for instance here. And if you say rectangle 2 equal to rectangle 6, this rectangle 2 will assign, is there a new operator here?
No.
If there is no new operator, so then it will not take memory. That this is a representative, okay? And it will assign to the same value. You understand that? It's not tricky, but same thing. So when a chairman sends his representative, so that he just acts what chairman was supposed to do, right? Okay, that means that then the representative becomes
Management supervisor has to be the manager.
That's it. For now, for this chapter, okay, we have one more thing. These operators, right? This operator is used. I'll tell you something. Okay, when I find something, I will tell you this operator later, okay? This operator is very important thing and very useful, but I will tell you later when we use.
If we get to the level, that time we can use for anything, this.
Yes, something. I will explain it in the program. I'll explain the program, okay? Okay, so now today, okay, there are some other things, but these are, I will discuss later.
Hello?
Yes.
Amar kotha ki shona jacche?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, now give attention, okay? We are discussing Java programming.